that damages of a termite infestation in any building can result to loss of money and time. In an event to get rid of them, some homeowners have yielded nothing but reoccurrences. The good news is that this can be fought proactively. Today in the Homes and Construction Affairs show, I have Lawrence Latigo, who is going to help us understand how to get rid of these termites. If you're out there and you have this problem already or planning to build a house, sit and learn on how you can save money. My name is Hilda Kamkam. What are the impacts of termites on any building?
When we talk about ants, this is one of any other kind of sector when it comes to the insect world that needs to be given almost a full day. Now, when you talk about straight away to the impact, before even explaining the ant itself, there's one grave kind of disadvantage that they do cause. First of all, they may cause a ceiling to bulge. So once a ceiling bulges in, definitely has to collapse. And we also have to look at the different kind of buildings we have. There are those that are cemented throughout, that are carrying cement and concrete kind of bricks. Then there are those ones that we do construct with the wood. So if you find your buildings so much made of wood, once a termite invades, they will really do away with it so easily.
Because of course we want to take off first, termites may invade or affect timber or wood. But can a termite also affect a concrete building?
Yes, it can. If we get more time, I'll take you around and show you how they are even dealing with real concrete and cement. One thing I should tell you about a termite, it is one small insect that even carries way bigger load than it is itself. It's a small kind of insect, but the load that it can carry is way too big that you can't believe.
Exactly, my question. I've been wondering, how can something as tiny as an ant or a termite cause us damages like what we are seeing in this compound?
Well, I must tell you that some of us confuse actually these two things. We have what we call the termites and then the flying ants themselves. So these two are quite distinctive, but they are working closely together. In short, that's the same way that you are looking at an army. An army, where we find the PGB, let's take an example of Uganda. The PGB, those are presidential guards. And then there's also another army that will also work closely to the PGB, but all under one umbrella as the army. So this also closely comes in when we talk about ants and the termites. Now, what enables them to do all that heavy load of work? That these ants or termites, they are having divens, or they are cut in two different kind of types, and also their work, but all under serving one umbrella, trying to serve to satisfy the queen ant.
So what are those different types of ants that you talk about?
Well, we do have quite several of them. All right, we have, we can talk about the trail line. We call them the trail line ants. These ones normally move in a line, okay, and collectively. So basically, normally they do act as transporters for food. They're also messengers. Some of you call them munyera. We also confuse them to be ensorosozi. But these two do the same work. But as
sometimes you call them, are they the doodles?
No.
No. Wow.
A doodle is very different. Now, when we come to talk about these black trail ants, basically, once you have an ant somewhere or the mold somewhere, they have these messengers which come in to look for food. Now, for them, as they come in, why we find this long queue or the queue of the line that follows normally, is that as they come to look for food, they secrete a certain hormone. This hormone is scented. So once they discover that there is some food which is not drying so soon, they create that scent, the scent-like hormone, that the others are going to be following to come and fetch that food and take back to the mold where the queen is. Basically, these ants or the termites are having different divisions, like I told you earlier. that each is having its own duty to serve.
So it means in a mall, yes, you can have several and different ants.
Exactly. So there are those that are dealing with security, specifically to only guard. There are those that are supposed to be building. There are those that are supposed to take food. There are those which are supposed to create a very conducive climate or environment for the queen bee, because the queen ant inside there is only supposed to be producing every day, every now and then. It's just to produce. Now, not until a certain time whereby these which have been produced earlier come to an extent that they're supposed to mate. Now, mating, which we call echiswa okubuka in Uganda, echiswa okubuka. By the time you find that echiswa okubuka is when we see the white ants now coming out and they spread their wings to the skies. Now,
the white
ants. So this is still under the same thing, the same category that we are now talking about. Now, by the time you see white ants flying and coming to the skies and spreading their wings, this is the time, actually, the irony is that they have come out to mate. So them coming out to mate, it is also mean that they are ready to go and start another colony.
So chances are that that white ant can also become a queen bee.
And that's why they are flying out. So by the time they try to come out and fly out, it's their time to mate and go create other colonies. Now what happened is, once they fly out both male and female. So after them mating, the male will die. The female will continue flying and try to create or look for a certain suitable place that it feels is going to be safe for it. This is where it will chance onto your house, it will chance onto your building somewhere, into your compound, the backyard. And once it lands, the wings will break off. Now, when the wings break off, it means you will never fly again into the skies. But it will use the offcuts of the wings as food now to feed it and gain the weight to start now laying the eggs.
Natuga, I'm taking you back to where you mentioned that you have different types of ants,
okay,
with different roles that they play.
Yes.
We have noticed several types of termites. So you are still telling us about...
The trail?
The trail ants.
Yes.
We have seen very, very more.
Mm-hmm.
Please, continue guiding us on the now, several types.
One way that actually helps us to fight those anthills or the molds into your homesteads, into your gardens, these things, what you should first of all note is that they don't build their molds where you can easily trace them. All I can tell you that the moment you see a reflection of a mold in your compound somewhere, just do not want to imagine what is beneath.
Wait a minute. My imagination is that if I see
something coming up,
like
it can,
because
yes,
this is obvious that these are ants.
Uh-huh.
What comes to my mind is that I dig down and pull out that maybe that's where the,
well, it could not be just so close as you may look at it, because like I've told you, they normally hide it somewhere. They also have different kind of work that they're going to do and hide and protect their premises. So the little reflection that you get here is also still trying to protect their territory that they do have. Basically, when we talk about a mold or an anthill, this is another creation. It's a world that sees them, see all the light, the love they want, and every other thing that you can imagine, like you're enjoying outside here. So they keep their place so secretive that you, a normal human being that has not acquired knowledge about them, may be hard for you to find. That is why we find so many of our architects, let's talk about the engineers, getting sites, and then after building their houses, the anthills invade. Because they did not take into study to devise means and find where the real anthill was or where the mold was. It's because these things hide. But now when you come to those that you know, the technical people who help you lead to where this source is supposed to be, they'll help you go and find it, dig it out, until die out. Remember, any army that still has the chief in command alive, it has not died. So not until you say that the chief in command has been maybe caught captive or it has been arrested, has been hit down, that's when that army can cease to stay.
I want you to guide us. How can a layman understand that this land maybe where they intend to construct any building.
Yes.
Has, and if that mold is not seen.
Okay. One thing, first of all, you must involve the professionals. Okay. We have to respect the fact that there are people who have taken their time to study these insects or to study certain things to help you do or achieve better.
Is there a course for those people or a general name for such professionals?
Fumigators.
They are the
rodent and pest controllers, yes. So, for example, for us, we do control pests. We do fumigate. So those are the people that you're going to go out and look for them. They're credible ones that are going to help you isolate and find out where you're supposed to deal with the ants away. But if you do not, you as a layman, all I can tell you, there are certain things that you can also follow. A little bit I can give you. We have what we call aphids. Aphids is a pest. It's normally lands onto flowers. It loves green. Now, this kind of aphid produces, also it secretes a hormone, like you see the other trailing black ants I told you about. Now, for it, as it is moving around the flowers, damaging them and feeding, it produces or it secretes that hormone, which the ants enjoy so much. So if you discover that either around your garden or around your flower beds, you find those kind of damages onto the leaves and all that, be very sure that you have ants around, because they almost move together. Reason being that this produces what they love most, so they cannot hide it up. Meaning that the moment you see them, you either kill the aphids to let the ants also disappear, because they will have nothing to eat.
And in an event where I don't see the aphids?
We also have other insects that come into the houses, that they slowly chew the ceiling boards, for example. You also have those the little trailing black ants I told you about, the likes of Lemniere and Sorosozi. Now, these other ants come in once in a while, but in the night, when everybody is quite awake. I think you one time maybe heard of someone saying that, we've been invaded by Sorosozi within the night. So them coming the night, they can help you, or they can lead you to their source, to their mold, because they create that line.
True.
Now, if you cannot follow them closely, this is when you're going to need the professionals to come in, and we set what we call an antibait. So the antibait would be some other thing that the ants will enjoy to eat, but when they look at it and they taste and all that is so nice, they will not want to eat from here.
So
it is another creation of kind of a pesticide, I should say, that once we apply it, it will stop these ants from producing or secreting that hormone I told you about, that scents or creates a scent that the others are going to follow to come and eat. So if they see that these ones are not coming in anymore, they will now tend to curry and take the other side for the others to also feed from there. Now, when they take the other side, you're going to find yourself destroying the whole colony at once.
So which one of the termites or which ants should we be more worried of, especially in construction?
Right. Now, what I must tell you is that by the time you see these ants flying out with the wings, those ones are not dangerous at all. But only be worried when they land. The moment you find one that doesn't have wings, if you can, just destroy instantly, because it is just looking for you to settle and start a colony straight away.
Because that's actually what happens in the morning. You wake up and you pick up.
So those that have no wings, they are the ones that straight away create the colonies, because that means they have landed and their wings, they cannot now fly anymore and are going to start. Now, we have what we call the soldier termites with the red heads. Those ones, the big ones, those are soldier termites. Those ones do not attack, but they chew anything, starting from wood. When you talk about pavement, actually, there are those ants we call the pavement ants. For them, once you look onto the walkways, they chew beneath. Whether you put a tile or you put a paver or something, they will try to create some kind of molds, but in a form of a tunnel.
Seriously?
I will take you through. You
because
will see.
I'm thinking if I have a tile,
yes,
I am protected. Whether how many termites or ants come, they can't affect my home.
Like I told you, building a mold is basically made out of dust. It can be made out of wood or any other thing. Because the ant has the capability to chew or bite and take and work. They work tirelessly and they will never stop. Not until the queen ant is dead. So once it is their duty to do, for example, I told you they have different kind of roles they play. There are those that just feed the unborn kind of ants, which are supposed to grow and later go on and create colonies. There are those which are protecting, those which are constructing, those who are bringing food. All of them are working closely together. So basically, once you start seeing those things like the Sorosozi, you see the red ants, you see them, just know that you are not so safe. But how do you, how are you going to be able to allocate or and identify that is this is an active ant here? That is where everybody is played.
Now, before we go to that bit of the active ant hill, it means that even if my home is safe from any ant hill,
yes,
I am not safe. Like, I'm not so prone to not having any.
Definitely.
Any time.
Yes.
As long as I can still receive those red ants that fly.
Because, like I told you, once they fly out, once they fly out and they are spreading their wings, they are mating. After mating, the male will die. The female will look out for a suitable place that it feels suitable for it to start nesting, to start creating a mold and start a colony. So if it moves in the sky and admires your area, whether your garage, whether your kitchen or somewhere, and it enters there, they will start from there. Remember, it is already fertile. It is, we should say it has finished mating, so it will produce. Once reproduction starts, termites will follow. And what do you have next is you seeing your things being chewed and eaten.
Can a queen ant die?
Yes.
How long does it take for it to just get destroyed completely?
Well, all I can tell you, for as long as it lives and it is producing, it will only die when the others fight it. Because you can find in one anthill, you may find you have more than one.
Can that happen?
Yes. You find an anthill has namunswa biri, or more than two.
Mm.
But normally where this thing is kept is again a little bit, it's like creating a gate within another gate, and then you create another fence. So it's highly protected, that its death is really uncommon. So unless, because as it grows older, the segments multiply. So those segments are also the number of eggs it is going to lay. So we are looking about a million eggs being laid every time it is laying. So its work will continue being like that unless it becomes too big. But normally, since we also have things that look for them, they are the ones which are going to just destroy it and kill it. Because with the protection it has from all the other sectors that I have mentioned about the ants, it is so hard to just let it die like that. So not until you, the human beings who really disturb them so much, come in. Oh, we talk about the porcupines which also go and hunt them, kill them, it will stay.
In a home?
Yes.
Like the one we're seeing now, how will I determine or know that there are ants or termites somewhere?
Okay. One, we have worktops in our houses.
Yes.
Now, those worktops, normally, since it's always in the kitchen side, if you happen to prepare a meal and leave some bit of food stuff onto the worktop, leave and go and sit somewhere, come back and find a lot of other kind of ants coming in. Normally, those ones are reddish in color, okay? Some of them, they want to look like a bikenembi, they call it a bikenembi, those which chew sugar or lick sugar, but they're not like that.
Mm.
So once you find them, be sure that you have an anthill somewhere. Because for them, they are in search for food, and they normally like investing in two areas where there is food, there is some kind of water, and also it's a little bit cold.
Yeah, we have always seen them, but we believe that the effect is not that alarming. So what are the effects?
You're just lucky, by the way, that if they have not yet eaten your home, maybe you find that their mold is quite distant from the real home, like where your things are, or they have so many other feeding grounds. Because as they feed or as they find different means of feeding, they may not try to so much endanger your home because they are also feeding from somewhere else. But if the only alternative is within your home, that's when you're going to see molds coming onto the pillars of the wall. You're going to find other molds coming onto the wall from the inside, the ceiling boards, any kind of woodwork that you do have within the house will start having those molds. So they're trying to create different kind of places where they would keep themselves safe as they also take or fetch food for the queen ant.
So how different is the wood rot dust?
Yes.
Different from the termite damage?
Okay, now the termite will confuse you in one way, or, in one way that it will chew your wood, for example. Let's talk about the ceiling. Because most of us have a lot of gypsum work and all that is burned. So they will chew and leave a very small, a tiny pinch of that wood that will still see it hold up there. And you may not easily realize that it has been eaten. So out of the blue, you may be seated into your cozy sitting room and enjoying life and the thing just bulges in to just collapse. But then if wood is rotting, water pours there, of course you'll see the dangers already there. That will give you time to come and even remove it, create another way and remove it. Unlike the termites, you look at it and take it for granted. You may think what you've seen is just a pinch from the outside, but from the inside, the whole thing has been eaten.
One thing I want everyone to understand.
Yeah.
If I see an ant, if I see a termite, should we really be worried?
I relate this question to when someone one time asked me about a bed bug. Bed bugs are very bad kind of insects. That if you see one on your shirt moving like this, coming out of your home, or you see one in a net somewhere, just know you have a million of them in the house. They hide so much. It's so hard to see them. So now, also the termites, the moment you start them coming, you should react with immediate effect before they really take over your home.
Can they really? Okay, what is the effect that they can make? How big or what is the magnitude of the damage that can be caused by those small insects?
We should also thank the technology that is forthcoming. Before, we used to find that almost a full home is to be built by poles, okay, normal wood, and then reeds. But currently we find we are getting use of iron bars, so much of the cement and all that. But back then, you would find your house would collapse on you. You will go and have a step somewhere where you think it is safe, but it has already been eaten, so that step missed, you lose a leg. So meaning that these termites are so dangerous to an extent that if you happen to have such kind of weaklings within a building, this building is always going to be reconstructed, redone. Because each time a piece is destroyed, you cannot join it, you need to replace, all right? So this is how dangerous they can be. They will not give you a warning shot that we are coming tomorrow, we are coming today, and they will not show you that warning shot that it is now ready to collapse. It will just die at once. You see, also these things have God in them, that as you're in, we should say this, because as you're within the building that has already been eaten properly and so supposed to collapse, God will still leave for you that small pinch on which it will hold until when you set a foot out and the thing will collapse on its own. So basically, this goes back to people always trying to find out and call fumigators to go and walk into their premises. You may, currently we should say people tend to be so busy. Leave home very early in the morning, come back late in the night and sleep. But these insects do invade our homesteads that we may take time to realize, but they are always there. So I would advise that people should do this thing maybe twice a year. Because as a fumigator comes in, it's going to fight against cockroaches and all that. That's when they're going to see the ants. And I advise that, oh, I've seen ABCD. I think an ant may want to come and pop around here. They hope you control and send it further. This is when you're going to find the fumigator creating the ant base that I've told you that they will carry into their colony, which will die eventually. But if you are not able to invite these people into your premises, that means you are also putting yourself at stake or in danger of finding these things invading your home that you cannot easily control, you'll find you're going to redo the whole building. So, like, I can take you around this fence. If we had not fought early enough, this fence would be brought down. First of all, it even kills the beauty of your home.
Yes, the beauty, I accept it.
It kills the beauty of your home. Now, apart from killing the beauty of your home, you look at all that you paint, all that you put, the quality of cement, it all weakens. So you just tap it like this, the thing dies away. Because they come and eat from the inside and destroy. Like I told you, the molds are built out of the dust or dirt itself, and then wood and any other kind of waste product you can use, because they can cut anything. So them coming onto the wall and they find this is suitable for their construction, they will keep on fairing it. Now, as they are fairing, they create like a simple kind of tunnel on top that you will always see something, but inside there is work being done. So they will eat it through. So before you know it, that part is falling off. Stermites.
It can collapse.
It can collapse.
It
can be eaten properly. Good enough, we are at a site where we have cement. A wall well built with cement. It has concrete within it. We are going to see all those marks.
So how long can it take for a termite to have a building collapse or a fence?
It will be unclear. The time will be very much unclear, but it will depend on how much termites have invaded in. For example, if you're to take on, let's say there's a war coming in, you taking down a full colony will need quite a number of soldiers to come and take it down. So it also depends on the grave that they have tried to like impose onto the building or onto the wall, and the surroundings, are they favoring for them to really continue working there?
We are going to go in a short commercial break. Our viewers, you have heard it. Right now, we are just taking a short break. But when we come back, we are going to look at how we can prevent the termites from invading our homes. Or if you've already had the molds around you, how do you fight them? We can also look at the techniques of building or construction. Are there any that can help us from this tragedy or from the termites invading our homes? All these ones after a short break. Stay tuned.